Let us discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of traditional and modern methods of teaching. So first, I would like to take the traditional teaching methods. The traditional methods of teaching are still prevalent in most parts of our nation. In educational institutions, teachers are the only source to gain information. Teachers explain the concept to the learners with the use of blackboard and chalk. They write all the content on the blackboard and ask the students to note down in their notebooks and memorize and recite the notes. All the focus of education in these institutions is to pass just the examinations. Now let us see some advantages of traditional teaching methods. Traditional teaching methods have many advantages. However, these advantages are the disadvantages of modern teaching methods. The traditional teaching methods, that is the classroom-based teaching, is not as expensive as modern teaching methods. So the rural areas can practice it with no stress of finance. In traditional methods of teaching, students form strong bonds with the teachers, and they interact more than modern teaching methods. Discipline can be maintained better in traditional teaching settings than in modern ways of teaching. There are some subjects like physics, chemistry, mathematics that need a blackboard explanation and can be understood well when explaining on a blackboard. The technical knowledge is not needed in traditional teaching methods like modern teaching methods, because modern teaching methods need more of a specialized approach. And unlike modern teaching methods, the traditional teaching methods do not harm the eyes of the students. The traditional methods of teaching that are still followed in most schools, what they follow? Number one, classroom are teacher-centric. The teacher will be standing, the students will be sitting and listening. The teacher will be talking and the students will be listening. Number two is chalk talk method is prevalent. Number three, teachers are only knowledge dispensers, still not facilitators. Number four, strictly organized and controlled classroom. Then no group learnings and problem solving sessions. Then clearing examinations are more important than grasping knowledge. Then homework-based education. And then absence of activity to sharpen the minds of the students. In traditional teachings, teachers are all responsible for learning and teaching environments. They play sole roles in making decisions and instructing the students. For them, the knowledge void of students has to be fulfilled with content, which can be provided only by them. Also, students are not able to interact with more students in their class as row sitting arrangements are still in use. So these are all about the traditional teaching methods. Stay blessed.